All right, guys. Yeah, as I said, I am back, and I just had to get some things set up and ready to go. I know I still have some messy stuff around from Cyndaquil's kind of. Let's kind of put Tyrant here, I guess. My big Tyrant plush. I had a lot of fun opening that. Again, if you're still here, Dragonider. Thank you so much for all of that. I had a lot of fun. Like, seriously, that was really good. If you're still here, I don't know if you are, but if you're still here, that was a lot of fun. Like I said, I'm gonna be streaming this, so I do need a drink though from all the talking from the last thing, so I didn't actually do that in between. And like I said, we wait about 5 minutes. So, we always wait about 5 minutes. I don't know who's still here, so if anybody is still here, please let me know. And don't just go away because I'm not doing anything yet in there. I don't want you to do that because, I mean, that would kind of ruin the point of doing this, I guess. But yeah. I don't know what I was saying anymore. I'm sorry. I kind of. But. Sorry, I'm looking at some things here. Man, that was a lot of fun opening that. I seriously. I mean, yeah, you did really good. I don't know, like I said, I don't know if anybody is still even here, but if they are, thank you for staying, and thank you for watching and everything. Apparently my stream quality is excellent. I have no viewers according to it though, so that's fine. It looks like people left. That's fine. I didn't honestly expect people to stay. It was a completely different thing that I'm doing now, so and it took me a little bit to get it up. I am, however, going to open my video manager while I wait for it to be about 5 minutes and upload the other one to YouTube. Export. And that's going to go up on YouTube, like I said. And then I'll put that in my post. I won't have pictures for a while because, like I said, I'm streaming. But those will be going up. So, oh, it does look like I still have viewers. That's great. Like I said, I guess if I have viewers, that's perfectly fine. I no reason to wait. I was just getting that video up on YouTube. So my quality may go down a little bit. Well, no, it shouldn't, because I'm not uploading from me. It's Twitch that's uploading. So, yeah. Anyway, I'm trying to figure out the best way to do this. They said he had it. Oh, he does have his tag. Okay. And it is the actual thing because it's got the Shop Pro sticker. I didn't show that before. It does have the Shop Pro sticker. So that's really cute. Really good. I don't know why I said cute, but. Anyway, if anybody is actually in my chat or watching, please let me know so that I know who is watching. Trying to move stuff around here a bit so I can have some room because I want Tyrant in the video, but he's kind of in the way right now. I guess he can kind of. I don't know. I'll figure it out. There we go. That works for now. But yeah, for now. We're gonna go ahead and go forward with this. We don't have to wait any longer because I can see I have people in my stream. So, anywho, we're gonna do the first one of today. Hopefully we can get our shiny today. That would be nice, wouldn't it? None there. Not for the first one. None there. None there. I'm really hoping for Mightyena. Mightyena is my favorite shiny out of these ones. Because Dewgong's just too close. Dewgong really needs to be, like, just a different color altogether. Right now, it's just a different color of white. And so it's... because a creamy white instead of a white white. Looks like some people left, but... you know, that's fine. I didn't expect that many people to stay. This is a lot of... the same thing. But I find it fun, so... I mean, you want to watch, you want to watch. You don't want to watch, you don't want to watch. That's perfectly fine with me. So. Anywho. If anybody is in here watching, let me know. Because I like having people to talk to, especially when I'm doing this. I really hope I don't get Sunkern, because that's going to suck, having to beat a Dewgong with a Sunkern. Whew. But, you know, shiny is a shiny. So. Oh, whoops. Let me check one thing here real quick. Sorry, I'm... okay, so... I was just looking at something. I probably lost some viewers there, but... there's some important stuff going on my Twitter that I missed completely because of, you know, streaming! Okay. This does get tiring after a while, but you know what? I still like to do it because it's just fun. I don't know, I find it fun. It may be tiring, but it's fun. I haven't really gotten that far in 10 minutes, to be honest. I've had a long day, so I'm already kind of... exhausted. So I may not do this for very long, but, you know... it doesn't have to be a long time. It's just... And sometimes that Sunkern just looks different in color, and it kind of worries me that I missed out on a shiny earlier. But I don't think I did. And I mean, if I missed out on a Sunkern shiny, I wouldn't be that disappointed because you know it's Sunkern, but yeah. I need to clean up my new bookshelves this weekend so I can display my collection properly too. My collections, I should say, because I got some new bookshelves. They just need to be cleaned up first before I actually try to display stuff on them. Because I'd rather not. And oh, I don't want to take Sunkern. Especially if it's not shiny. Long day today. Long, exhausting day today. I just kind of realized that Tyrant is on this side when I have Cyndaquil plushes behind me on this side, and then Cyndaquil is on this side when I have Tyrant plushes behind me on this side. So they're on the opposite sides. Whoops. Oh well. They kind of fit better because I don't have as much room on my right side. Because I have a pillow that I need to move. If I move the pillow properly, it would have more room, but I'm trying not to squish the tyrant because I don't want to squish him. But anyway. Don't know if I actually press the plus button for that or the equal button, but made it go up by one, but whatever. If I'm off count by one, then it's not that big of a deal. Whew. Man, why am I so tired? It's just been a long day. I drove around everywhere too. The Pokemon, I mean, I originally went to Toys R Us at like 10 o'clock, and then they told me they wouldn't be doing it until noon, and so I'd have to leave and come back or wait there for 2 hours, and I certainly wasn't gonna wait there for 2 hours. No. Oh wow, I have quite a few viewers. But I mean, I did manage to get my stuff. I went to GameStop, talked to the guys there for a bit, went back to Toys R Us, and then. But they're quite a ways apart. They're like half an hour apart. So, unfortunately, there's only one Toys R Us in my city, and there's only, or and there's a few GameStops, but. The GameStop I like to go to is like, and I don't have signal where there's the Toys R Us, so I had to just go to where I knew there was a GameStop. And it gave me, I mean, it lasted enough time that I was able to get to GameStop and go back to Toys R Us without having to go back home or anything. So. Oops. May have to eat some of these sweets that Dragonite got me. If anybody is actually here and can talk in the chat, please do so I can. Have someone to talk to. I appreciate it when I have someone to talk to. The viewers keep going up and down though, so I don't know who is actually here and who's not. Oh, hey, Dragonider, you're still here. Thank you for staying. Appreciate it. I know some people in Pokemon Collectors may not like that I'm using an emulator or whatever, but I mean, like I said, for YouTube and Twitch, sometimes you have to do stuff that's different if you want anybody to catch people's. Attention. Because if you don't, I mean, nobody's gonna care. If you're doing the same thing that someone bigger is, then why would they care? And a lot of people do Heart Gold, Soul Silver, Shiny Badge quests. I haven't heard of anyone do a randomizer Shiny Badge quest. So, yeah. Be wrong, maybe there are some people that do, but I just think it gives a nice little twist to it so that you don't know. I like randomizing. It gives a nice little twist to it so you don't know what's coming up, because if you, like I said, if you do the same thing that everybody else has done, everybody's used to seeing you hunt for Cyndaquil, Totodile, Chikorita. Everybody's used to seeing you hunt for the ones that are normally in the route, but now I will get the chance to, I mean, like, maybe I'll get a freaking, like, a Dratini in the first route. Or something like that. Or a Gible or something. Something you wouldn't expect. Kind of like you'd never expect to see Sunkern, Dugong, and Mightyena for the starters. Completely random. I'm gonna go look at something real quick. I have more friends on Facebook than I think, apparently. I don't care about those supposed friends because I don't know them. Or I do and I don't really, I mean, that's not, yeah, I, you know what I mean. Okay, I was just checking to see if there's anything new and anything yet. Anyway, I'm kind of just rambling on because nobody's here to actually, I mean, I know you're here, Dragonider, I like to have people to actually talk about stuff. People who are here, what do you think about the whole Sun and Moon, Pokemon Sun and Moon thing? I guess I didn't promise my stream would be spoiler-free. I mean, I didn't say anything about it before on the Pokemon Collector's side, but, I mean, there actually is one more thing I need to do here. Let me check YouTube here real quick. I really don't think we're going to get anything related to Sinnoh. I really don't. And the reason I say that is because what? I'm without your kisses, I'll be needing stitches. Is that like a song or something? Apologize if I don't know what that is. I don't really listen to music that much, honestly. I am actually fixing my video on Twit or on YouTube real quick for my previous thing here. So hold on one moment. It's gonna go up shortly here, so. Oh, okay. Well, welcome to the stream, Healers Protect. Sorry, I'm not actually doing anything right now. Like I said, I uploaded the what I was just doing previously to YouTube, and so I'm, no. There we go. Oh, no, you know what? I'm gonna put it in both of those. I'm gonna save changes because this video actually needs to go up on. Site, so yeah. Anyway, I'm done with that. Leave this page, and then I will go ahead and start doing this again. I'm sorry that I had that little lull there and not doing anything. But I mean, at least I was talking to you and explaining to you what I was doing. How are you guys all doing? And let's see here. But yeah, I know I just asked how you guys are all doing, but I think I kind of paused on what I was saying. I don't think that we're gonna have Sinnoh Remix. I don't think that Sun and Moon are gonna be Sinnoh Remix. We just had. First off, we just had our last games were Omega Ruby and Alpha Sapphire. They're not gonna do two remakes right back to back, especially when the graphics change isn't that huge for. Fourth gen to sixth gen. We're not gonna have Sinnoh remakes yet. Not this soon after the last remakes. Second, the way they did the montage in the Pokemon Direct, they're not gonna be Sinnoh remakes because the only games they mentioned throughout, well, when they did the little montage up leading up to announcing Pokemon Moon, and they were like saying the years and stuff. They were saying the years of the each main series game came out. Like they said that like Red and Blue, Silver and or Red and Green, Silver and Cri Gold and Silver, Ruby and Sapphire, Diamond and Pearl, Black and White, X and Y. And so they said like 1996, 1999, 2002. And then I think it went to 2006, 2010, 2013, and then 2016. I am personally kind of disappointed that they're doing X and, or that they're doing Sun and Moon and not Z. They're leaving Gen 6 incomplete, and it just doesn't make sense. Pokemon Go will be fun. I can't wait for that either. That's not something that you can really, unfortunately, that's not something that you can really record and share with people, but I mean, maybe I'm wrong, but I don't think you can unless you have someone carrying a camera behind you. But I'm not as excited for Pokemon Go as I probably should be. Like I said, I'm not as excited with everything because I think they should have finished off Gen 6, and now they're not, but hey, what can you do? No, what did I do? There we go. Sorry if that looked weird. I hit the minus sign instead of the equal sign on my calculator. My goodness, this is taking forever. I hope I get this today. I'll be super excited if I get this today. But you know, it may just not like me. And I just lost like all my viewers somehow. I'm down to two, it says. I did go up in viewers for a while, but then it just dropped right back down to two. Now it's at three. Don't really care though. People don't like it when people focus on their how many viewers they have. Whoops, I did the wrong thing. There we go. Man, I'm trying to make it so that my Cyndaquil's more in the. There we go. That's fine. Yeah, my fat belly. Anyway, nobody answered me. How's everybody doing? Having a good day. Good Pokemon anniversary. I really hope I find this thing soon so I don't have to sit here and soft reset all the time. Soft resetting is the most tiring form of shiny hunting, I swear. Especially when I don't have anything else going on. I don't have any, like, nobody's talking that much. And when I'm shiny hunting and I'm watching like a TV or something, then it's a lot easier, but. Oh well. Nope, don't go with Sunkern, please. Especially when it's not shiny. I will do that every once in a while, and I swear to God, that's probably where I'm missing my shinies. Is when I accidentally pick Sunkern with just like keep clicking through and accidentally pick Sunkern. But yeah. And like I just did it. I was totally not paying attention and I just did it. Oh my goodness, I am such. Oh. And it may have even been a shiny Sunkern, but I have no idea because I can't tell because I didn't see it. I was completely not paying attention and I adopted, or why do I keep saying adopted? I got Sunkern. I chose Sunkern without paying attention. I don't want to choose Sunkern. I just don't. Unless it's shiny. And even then, it's gonna be a pain in the butt. Come on, game. Give me a shiny. I don't remember what the odds are for this. I don't think I'm over odds yet, but I don't remember. Well, no, I think I am actually, because of the fact that I'm getting three at once. I think I am quite a bit over odds. Anywho. Sorry if I'm quiet. I tend to get quiet when I run out of things to say and there's nobody to kind of instigate conversation. Don't know why I keep humming. Tend to do weird stuff like that when I don't have. When I'm just sitting here doing this. He's not as soft as I wanted him to be, but you know, I expected that with a Banpresto plushie. The Banpresto. Although I do like how small Banpresto tags are. They don't, like, take up the whole thing. Unlike some. I'm wondering if my Target has some of those Mew collection boxes still, because that's where I got mine. I kind of want to open more of them, because I didn't get Jack Squat out of mine, to be honest. But at the same time, I have a feeling like if I keep getting more of them, then I'm going to get sick of them. Because there's going to be more boxes throughout the year. One for each month, starting in February. Mew, Celebi, Jirachi, Manaphy, Darkrai, Arceus. Victini, Genesect. There might be more that I'm missing. Mew, Celebi, Jirachi, Manaphy, Darkrai, Arceus. Victini. Yeah, I'm missing Shaymin. I miss Shaymin in there. Come on, shinies. Thank you. Anyone there that can talk in the chat? Okay, hold on one moment here. Okay. No, I forgot Keldeo. That's what I forgot. And Meloetta. Whoops. Whoops, whoops, whoops. It's hard, because, like, Mew is the only first gen one. Celebi is the only second gen one. Third gen gets Celebi. Fourth gen gets Darkrai, Manaphy, and Shaymin. And Arceus. Fifth gen gets... Yeah. Gets five as well. Victini, Keldeo, Genesect, and Meloetta. Which I think is kind of silly, but whatever. Anyway, back to the actual stream, now that I'm not, that I've already, looked at some stuff, although I do need a drink. Well, Dragonite, I have bookshelves that I got from my mom last weekend, but I need to clean them off. And, I mean, this is just my plushes, to be honest. My plushes and this. Just because I can't put this in a box or a bag. I needed bookshelves to display my collection of figures and stuff. Otherwise, my cat will snag my figures and knock them around. So, I've got, like, I don't know if it's loose skin or what it is, but it's really bugging me on my finger. So, I have to clean those bookshelves off because I don't want to put anything on them while they're dirty. But, other than that, I mean, so far, right now, most of mine are on my couch. Stop, stupid computer. But that may change. I don't know if I want to move it. Some people think it's really cool for when I'm streaming to have all those plushes behind me. But at the same time, in some of my videos like this one, you can't even see them all. Like, it cuts off on at the end of my Cyndaquils, and you can't even see some of my Cyndaquils. So, man, he's got such a big head. Such a big head. He's headbanging. Like, seriously, his head is huge compared to the rest of his body. That's just how a Pokemon is. It's just... it's supposed to be... I think it's taller? Yeah, it's taller from than my Cyndaquil plush from the tip of the tail to the nose. I'm trying not to bend the tag or anything. It's not very, like, cuddleable. It's definitely a display plush. Definitely. I could see me doing, like, Cyndaquil plushes and stuff on my couch once I get enough and just have Cyndaquil plushes. That would be pretty cool. Kind of leaning in front of my Cyndaquil plushes, but... and something just fell down on my... oh, it was my dish that had soup in. Fell down on my floor. It's plastic, so it's not gonna hurt it to fall down on my floor. Yeah, for now, that's where most of my plush stay, or really all of my plush stay, is on my couch. Because I especially don't want to put plushes on my bookshelves that are dirty. I want to clean those off first. Talked about moving it before, and some people just, as far as like putting them on bookshelves and stuff, so I can display them as like the whole Cyndaquil collection and the whole Tyrant collection together. But then some people were like, but no, it looks so cool behind you when you stream, having all those plushes back you. I think it's sweet. Or behind you, I think it's sweet. You can't even see like my Amora plushes. You can't see my Yveltal plush. You can only see like the arm of the Yveltal plush, or the wing. You can't see my Fennekin plush, you can't see my Ninetales plush. And I'm sitting in front of my Mantyke plush. Can't see my Squirtle plush. Can see my Bulbasaur and my Totodile. My Chikorita if I move the right way. Mostly what you're seeing is Tyrants. Because I have a lot of Tyrants. And Axew. You can see Axew, I guess. I don't know why I got Axew, to be honest. It was just cute when I thought it was cute when I first saw the plush. For, you know, it was like $6, and I was already buying something from him, so. I really wish Kangaskhan had a plush, like, seriously. I wish I could afford customs, but I can't. I can't. I really shouldn't have bought this because it was too much money for me, but it was, I mean, one of those where if I didn't buy it, I would regret it. What? Same here about what? I don't remember what I said that you would have said same here about, to be honest. Oh, a Kangaskhan plush. Yeah, Kangaskhan is my second favorite Pokemon, and it doesn't have any plush. It's even a Mega, and it doesn't have a plush yet, which is so disappointing to me. Like, it's not like Mega Kangaskhan would be hard for them to make. I mean, it's probably one of the easiest Megas for them to make. I mean, I can't imagine Mega Gengar was that easy. I can't imagine that Mega Mawile was that easy, but they both have plush. So I don't understand why Kangaskhan just gets the shit stick when it comes. Sorry about my language, but she does when it comes to plushes. Doesn't get anything. Been around since first generation and hasn't gotten anything as far as plushes go. So disappointing. Like, it's not even that there's super rare plushes out there. There is nothing. If you want Kangaskhan plush, you have to get a custom, and I can't afford customs. Can't justify spending $50 for a plush this size. When official plushes like that are like $25, $20. I can't. Can't justify spending like twice to three times the money on a plush just because it's custom. I understand you're putting your own work in it, but I do understand that people put their own work into it and their own resources, but people expect minimum wage for that stuff, and it's just not worth it to me. I can't justify it. I can justify spending $40, $50 on a plush like this big. I can justify spending, especially when they're official plush, and they're not that easy to find. They're pretty rare. I can justify spending a couple, like, over $150 on this guy because he's a big plush and he's rare. Heck, if I had the money for it, I could even justify spending the $800 or whatever that I'd have to spend to get the giant Snorlax plush. Because it's freaking 5 feet tall, man. 5 feet. If I had the money for that, I would totally be able to justify it. I don't know where the like I'd put it, but I would be able to justify the money spent on it. dang, like 52,000, I think is what it was, yen for that thing. And then you gotta calculate shipping on top of it. That thing's gonna be insane. I mean, it would like, I swear it would like replace my bed. I wouldn't really want to sleep on it because I wouldn't want to make get it dirtied up with my grossness, but I couldn't think of doing anything else with it. Just put it on top of my bed and sleep on it. Let my cat sleep on it. But like, if you get a plush this size, people expect like $200-$300 for it. And I just like knew this would have been like 40 when it first came out. I know they don't do it in necessarily great ways, but you can't, can't justify. That kind of money. Like some people can, I guess. I mean, it's different when it's like your main collection. Like this is worth it to me because it was my main collection. But as far as like, I don't know, because you don't know how the customs are going to turn out until after they're done. You could end up not really liking it at all. Could end up disappointed. Much as I want like a custom Kangaskhan plush, I don't know if I can trust anybody to do it right, other than Pokemon. And as much as I want a shiny second gen shiny Cyndaquil plush, I don't think anyone's going to be willing to make that for me for a decent price. Hi Yoshi 67893. Welcome to the stream. Welcome, welcome. Thanks for coming. How are you doing today? I'm doing all right, thank you. Thank you. Did you go around to GameStop and Toys R Us and get the Pokemon Day stuff? Might get Pearl. That's cool. My guess right now is that Toys R Us is probably out of stuff. I don't know how long they were doing it, but they started at noon. And there were a lot of people at mine, and I didn't think there were that many people around that liked Pokemon that much, but there were a lot of people around that went to Toys R Us. But again, there was also... We actually We only have one Toys R Us here, so... That probably doesn't help the matter that, like, everybody who wanted the Toys R Us stuff went there. Because there's only one Toys R Us. $42.50. I like randomizers because it gives you something different, so you're not with the same Pokemon that you're used to throughout the game. And since people do shiny badge quests all the time, I wanted to mix up what I was hunting for as far as shinies go. I didn't want to go for the same ones that everybody does. Even though Cyndaquil is my favorite Pokemon. Yeah. But I still haven't gotten anything as far as shinies go in this. I can almost guarantee you at this point that at somewhere down the line I missed a shiny Dewgong or Sunkern. Especially since sometimes I accidentally choose Sunkern and because I'm not paying attention, I just keep pressing Z, which is the whatever, A button or whatever. Oh my goodness, I'm sorry. Alright, Dragonite-er, you have a great rest of your Pokemon day, and thank you for the SSS package, and thank you for coming and watching the stream and everything. And yeah, you did a great job. Thank you so much. I'll definitely leave you feedback at some point tonight. Yeah, definitely. Have a great night. Hold on one moment here, guys. Heck. Sorry, I'm looking at something. Anyway, let's get done with looking at that. I think I'm gonna go to about. Oh my goodness, I keep clicking off of. Like, clicking just barely off of the window, and it keeps going off the screen. But, think I'm probably gonna go to 4500 maybe tonight. Because otherwise it'll wear on me pretty much. I was able to do 1900 one night, but that I wasn't already exhausted. That was a birthday stream, so I was like forced myself to do it. I have to actually go to the bathroom real quick, so I will be right back. Don't go away. Like I said, I'm just going to the bathroom, so it'll be a few moments in at the most. So, hold on. Whoops, I thought I had a. Control R so that it had would do that for you guys, but apparently I forgot. Whoopsies. Tyrant, I don't know what I'm gonna do with you. Kind of in the way right now. Is there any way I can get you to kind of just sit up there for now? Come on, Shiny. Where are you at? $4,300. Dang. Come on. Shiny, please. This shiny is giving me problems. Sorry. Come on, jeez. I don't know why I do this to myself sometimes. I know some people have a lot more soft reset for a shiny, but I'm not used to this. I'm used to XY shiny hunting, where I get like a shiny in less than 1,000 encounters most of the time. Most of the time. Not saying all of the time, but most. Apparently I still have 3 viewers. I don't know who they are. I'm guessing, well, one of them's me, but... yeah, I'm probably gonna go to 4,500 and then go do some other stuff. Nothing yet. Sorry. I shouldn't do this right now, but. Excuse me, jeez. Yeah, there's not many people here. I'm sorry, I'm quiet. I am quiet, but there's not many people here. There's nobody talking, so. I don't really see, at this point, a point to talk because there's nobody here listening. I'm just gonna keep doing my thing. Get to 4,500 tonight. Unless I find it before then, obviously, but. Check something real quick. Sorry, I'm looking at something. Okay. I'm done with that for now. Yep, I'm the only one here. I am the only one here, and nobody is talking to me because I'm the only one here. I'm the only one here. Oh, hi, the fuzzy bra. The fuzzy bra. Sorry. Sorry about my little humming. Nobody was here, and so I was just kind of trying to keep myself from getting bored. Kind of interesting timing for you to come in. Oh, wow. But thank you for following. Welcome to the stream. How are you doing today? I feel goofy now. Sorry. Not as big. No, I'm gonna leave him over here so people can see him. I just realized my Cyndaquil's not really visible. Not really visible. 4,400, no shiny. Okay, about 100 more if I don't find it, and I'm gonna be, and then I'm gonna end off the stream for tonight. Come on. Come on. What am I doing, noob gamer? I am doing a shiny badge quest, and it's randomized. And if you don't know what a shiny badge quest is, it's a, pretty much what you have to do is you have to find a shiny before you complete each of the gems. And so what I'm doing right now is soft resetting for a shiny randomized starter. And these are what they randomized out to be, so. It's shiny hunting. Pretty much, at this point, right now. I haven't gotten to the storyline yet, because I'm still shiny hunting the starter. So. That's why I have the shiny versions of these up on the top left where it says current hunt. That's why it's called Soul Silver version shiny badge quest. All that. Come on. Come on, shiny. I'm going till 4,500 and then I'm ending it off for today because I've been doing it for quite a while already. But and I can only do it for so long before I get worn out of it, so. Soft resetting is my least favorite type of shiny hunting, but this is the best way to do it at the beginning. So, I mean, I guess maybe I could go off into the grass, but I'm not gonna do that. I mean, I'd have to go through the whole story before I have a chance of catching a shiny, and then watch me just walk into the grass and find a shiny before I have Pokeballs. That would be terrible. Absolutely terrible. two numbers, like the viewers and the chatters keep switching numbers off and on. Like it keeps, like eventually the viewers will go up by one and go to three, but then the chatters will go down by one and go down to two, and they'll reverse. So it's kind of, so it must not be in sync or something. I love how I pointed at my screen like you guys knew what I was talking about. Up there. Now they're 3-3. I mean, it's not like that's really that important to me, but... Dugong and Sunkern are super hard to tell. I mean, they're not terribly hard, but when going through like this, they're pretty darn hard to tell. I mean, at least Mydian is a completely different color. Okay, we got five more after this before I end it off for today, so. Now we got four more. Three more. Two more. One more after this. Alright, 4,500 is coming up. 4,500 or Riot. Shiny or Riot. Mydiana, no shiny. Dugong, no shiny. Sunkern, shiny. Darn it. Okay, looks like we're gonna have to stream again at some other point for this, to get this. Anyway, yeah, this is, Tiamat Ruler signing out, and I will see you guys next time. Thanks for watching, and have a great day. Peace.